A huge jolt of excitement this afternoon with claims that signs of life have been detected in the deep ocean where a tourist submarine has gone missing. But there is no official verification. The search does remain active tonight and time is still running out.
In the air, on the water, under the water, no effort is being spared. But until an hour or so ago, there was nothing to comfort the families of those missing.
It's not good. It really isn't good. It will be a miracle if the crew returns alive.
And then a Rolling Stone magazine report claiming Canadian authorities had told the US they'd picked up banging noises every 30 minutes coming from the deep. The Explorers Club, which counts two of the missing as its members, then claimed likely signs of life have been detected. The US Coast Guard says searches were shifted based on those noises. They have so far yielded negative results, but continue.
We're all crossing fingers, toes and absolutely everything.
Australian Glenn Singleman has gone down to the Titanic and trained others on survival techniques.
They're trying to be staying calm so that they use less oxygen. I mean, it's the clock is ticking.
If alive, they have one day's air left, and it's not clear how they can be brought to the surface.
If the sub is located, that's a question that then the experts need to look at what is the best course of action for recovering the sub.
It remains as likely the five men, including a teenager, have already met a catastrophic end. Standing at sea level, the air pressure on us is 15 pounds per square inch. It's called one atmosphere. Go down 10 metres into water and that doubles to two atmospheres. At Titanic depths, the pressure is almost 400 atmospheres, precisely 380 times the pressure on us standing on the shore.
The pressure is like having a bus stacked onto your wrist.
Just last October, the now missing captain described the destruction of a prototype in the lab under precisely those pressures.
Now I'm standing next to this chamber and we blow this thing up. It's the loudest thing I've ever heard. It shook the whole building, blew out all the pressure sensors.
Tonight, though, there is a sliver of hope, the best since contact was lost. Hugh Rimmington for 10 News First.